A patient is bleeding uncontrollably and the clock is ticking. The prothrombin time test could be the difference between life and death. As a lab technician, your expertise in this test directly impacts whether that patient survives. Let's unlock the power of the PT test. At the end of this video, I will share a bonus tip that will make you a pro lab technologist. Introduction to the PT test. The prothrombin time PT test is necessary for any lab technician. It measures how long it takes blood to clot and evaluates the extrinsic and common coagulation pathways. But why is it so important? We use the PT test to assess clotting issues and monitor patients on anticoagulants like warfarin. Principle of the PT test. The PT test measures the clotting time by activating the extrinsic pathway. By adding tissue factor and calcium to a plasma sample, we start a cascade that forms a fibrin clot. This time-based process helps us gauge how well certain clotting factors like factor 7, XV2, prothrombin, and fibrinogen are working. Quick tip. Remember this. PT stands for prothrombin timing. It's all about the timing of clot formation. Step-by-step PT test procedure. Manual method. 1. Prepare platelet. Pour plasma. PPP. Centrifuge the blood sample at 2500-3000 degree for 10-15 minutes to obtain PPP. This is the base of our PT test. 2. Warm the plasma. Take 100 UL PPP sample in a 37 degree C water bath or heating block for a few minutes. Keeping the plasma at body temperature ensures accurate clotting results. 3. Add tissue factor, TF. Once warmed, add 100 UL of tissue factor, tissue thromboplastin, to the plasma. Mix it and incubate for 1 to 2 minutes. Tissue factor activates the extrinsic pathway. 4. Add calcium chloride. Quickly add 100 UL of pre-warmed calcium chloride and start the stopwatch. Calcium activates the clotting process. 5. Record clotting time. Watch the reaction closely and stop the timer when you see a visible clot form. The time recorded is your prothrombin time, PT. Always run the test in duplicate for more accuracy and average the reading by simple calculation of mean formula. Automated method. In many labs, automated analyzers are used. Here, the machine handles the mixing, timing, and measurement, giving you results faster and more consistently. Understanding PT results. PT and INR. Typically, PT values range from 11-13.5 seconds. For patients on anticoagulants, we calculate the INR, International Normalized Ratio, to provide a standardized value. This helps doctors ensure patients' blood is within a safe clotting range. Key points. Normal PT. A PT value of 11-13.5 seconds is usually considered normal. INR normal range. The INR is usually between 0.8 and 1.2 for healthy patients. If it's higher, it indicates slower clotting, which may suggest anticoagulant therapy or clotting disorders. Interpreting abnormal results, prolonged PT. This indicates slower than normal clotting, which can point to vitamin K deficiency, liver disease, or effects of warfarin. Shortened PT. Though rare, a shorter PT may occur with specific factor replacement treatments. Memory tip. Think of PT as potential trouble when it's prolonged. It signals potential clotting issues. Precautions for accurate PT testing. For reliable results, follow these best practices. Blood to anticoagulant ratio. Always maintain a 9.1 ratio of blood to citrate. Sample handling. Avoid hemolysis, which can disrupt clotting results. Calibrated instruments. Regular calibration of machines keeps your results consistent. Bonus tip. When preparing PPP, always remember, gentle handling is key. Rough handling or improper mixing can activate clotting factors prematurely, giving false results. Treat each step with care, and your PT test will be accurate every time. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more lab tips.